What's up, everybody? Kellen Stankus, back at you again today. Hope you guys all enjoyed my episode 4 of Torben Sanity, Lord of the Rings, the Knickerbocker figures. I had a lot of fun making it, and it was a long time coming, but I hope you enjoyed it. If you haven't seen it, click the link down below there in my my channel. Maybe it's not below this video, but go to my channel, you'll see it. Toy Room of Insanity, episode 104. In the Mego world, there's been a lot of discussions about Wave 6 that's coming out very soon. And I'm still confused, and I know myself and many of you guys out there can get caught up with reality, which is basically work or whatever else you guys do outside of your hanging out on the internet. But where did I miss Wave 5? What's in Wave 5? I don't know what Wave 5 is. Maybe I'm missing something. I have no clue. So if you guys can clue me in, I'd appreciate it. Leave a link down below to whatever Wave 5 is, or maybe you can give me just a quick description in the comments of what Wave 5 is. I don't know. But let's talk real quick about Wave 6. I know what that is. We have a couple more Star Trek figures coming out. There's a Trouble with Tribbles Spock. He's in his blue, regular blue outfit, which is cool. He does not have the Live Long and Prosper fingers going on, hand salute. He comes with Tribbles. There's also a new Gorn that's glow in the dark. His ridges on the top of his head and his horns are glow in the dark. That's pretty cool. And we got another green shirt, like the one we already had at Target. Trouble Tribbles. He comes with Tribbles, you know, which is cool. So if you couldn't get the other Kirk that was Target exclusive, you can get this one. And then there's some more monsters. Cool, which is awesome. There's a second version of Freddy, which apparently is going to be the last version that Mego's going to be able to do. Apparently something went awry with their license, who knows what. But they can't do any more Freddy figures, which is a bummer. Nightmare on Elm Street, rather. But I guess this figure is going to have the correct color on his glove. Because the glove that came out already is like a dark green, like a dark olive green maybe. And now this one's going to have a brown glove. So that's great. And you guys already know we have the werewolf, the Flock werewolf. That's pretty cool. That's a cool figure. We have another Nosferatu, and going in the theme of, like I was saying, I hope Mego does glow in the dark figures. We just have to have those. That's I think that's an awesome idea. Very retro. That's huge to have that. But we have the glow in the dark Nosferatu, same card art, but yeah, this lovely picture of him on the side there, animated art of him, which is really cool. I love it. And we have another Frankenstein. This is what do people call him? The re-put together or reconstructed Frankenstein. That's what they call him. So he's got no shirt. Basically, it's the same Frankenstein. I don't know if he's glow in the dark. He doesn't say it, but it looks like it. Maybe it's not. But he has no shirt. He's got some stitches here going on his chest and a little different. Same thing on his head sculpt. He's got some blood behind him. Probably that's part of the card art. So it'll be interesting to get that out and find out what the deal is on that. But I love the card art. I mean, that's an awesome picture of Frankenstein. And the next, what's interesting, what everybody's kind of freaking out about is the glow in the dark Dracula. Like, what's the deal, man? He's got a goatee, and there's so many weird renderings of Dracula over the years. But I think this is pretty cool. I was expecting to be Bela Lugosi, but it is not Bela Lugosi. It's just a Dracula figure. It's glow in the dark with a purple inner lining on his cape. That's cool though. But I believe that's all of Wave 6. Yeah, 6, sorry. Get confused here. I'm sorry. What the hell is Wave 5? But in this video, let's move on forward. We're gonna go back into the accessories for the vintage Planet of the Apes line that Mego did back in 74 and 75. So we're gonna stick again in the world of 75. If you guys haven't watched my last couple videos I did, the accessories, we have one more to go after this. But there's one more accessory that did come out in 1975. And let's look at that one right now. All right, so here's the box for the catapult and wagon made by Mego for the Planet of the Apes toy line that came out again in 1975. Each side of the box does have the same bit of artwork on it, as you can see. Each side, and both sides have the same, just generic orange flap on the side, Planet of the Apes catapult and wagon with the lovely round Mego logo that they had back in the day. But loving the artwork on here again. Mego had someone do some really cool, again, some great artwork for their accessory sets, actually tons of their stuff back in the good old glorious days of Mego. And I love seeing here the catapult being ridden by General Urko here in the back, and a couple soldier aides. I'm just wondering what this guy's worried about, because he's looking back at him. Maybe he's just worried his boss is going to fall off. I don't know. But let's go ahead and get into the catapult and wagon right now. All right, so here's the catapult and wagon. And the catapult's on the back, wagon's in the front, so wouldn't that be the normal way, right? Inside the wagon, there are 12 boulders that it came with, 12. So if you have this set and you do not have 12 of these, then your set is incomplete, oh my God. But it did come with 12, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12. And no, I did not make that up. That is actually the amount that's supposed to be in there. So mine came with 12. Check it. It is fact. The wagon is molded in just a brown plastic. It has no paint apps. Absolutely not at all. But it does have some grain in the wood to make it look like wood. So it does have some detail to the actual sculpt, which is pretty cool. It does have four wheels that do all spin all the way around, right? On the back is the hitch for to pull the catapult. And then up in the front is what appears to be I'm sorry, I don't know all the terms for horses and animals. You would think this would go on a horse, right? I guess, right? Is that what we're gonna get to in the next video? But that is in front there too. I mean, I guess you could have a human stand in front and pull it if you wanted to. Why not? You know, it's whatever imagination. And this piece does come off. I'm not gonna mess with it, but it does come off the front of it if you wanted it to. Why not? The inside of the, there it goes, it fell right off. The inside of the wagon looks just like so. Can see the mold of the how they made the grain of the wood on it. Looks pretty cool. You know, I guess you could take some black acrylic paint and put like a nice black wash on it and dirty it up. That would look really, really cool to do. I don't see why not. But that's it. I mean, as far as the bottom goes, that's what you get, what you expect. But you know, it's made of plastic, not super thin, but you know, it's durable. You know, it could be easily broken, but still cool piece to have for your plan of the upset. Let's look at the catapult. The catapult's made in the same type of brown basic plastic, nothing amazing about it. Has the two wheels up in front that do spin around. This is supposed to be pulled, right? There is that little piece of felt that's here that came with it. I think that it's not felt, I'm sorry, it's like a foam. I believe it came with it for the packaging, but I guess you could keep it on if you wanted to, but I'm pretty sure that just was in there with the packaging, so it's kind of neat, it's still on there. Here is the actual piece to catapult your rocks or anything, right? You could put the fit in this little piece right here, so you can see. This kind of, whatever is big enough that will fit right on top of it, won't fall through, you can put on top of that and launch it. There is this little piece over here that pulls out. You could kind of lock that into place, as you can see. So when you're ready to use this thing, you can pull this out and push it back in and have it in, I guess, launch mode. Or actually, what you're supposed to do, I'm thinking about this now, because I've never actually set this thing up to do it to launch anything. I'm not going to, I don't want to break it. But you're supposed to set up rubber bands on this, and I'm guessing you could do two of them. You can see there's a couple slots here, one here, and there's also one right on the side over here. And you do two rubber bands down to here, and I guess you could use this to hold it and keep it into place, right? You put your boulder on here, just like so, and then, you know, you got your tension on your rubber bands and just pull this out and then it would launch. Wow, not bad at all. It's a neat little piece for Planet of the Apes. This is probably one of the coolest that they did. Actually, they're all cool. I should stop saying that, but I'm glad they made this. That's the way I should say. Here's a top shot, top view of the catapult, as you can see. Again, the molding has the grain of the wood on it. And the bottom, nothing. I think it has some information here. I can't really see too well about Mego, probably, where it was made, copyrights and all that. But very, very cool. And let's take another look at this thing all together. I want to show you guys one more thing with this. All right, so now that it's back together again, I want to show you a feature that is a very simple feature, but something maybe you guys didn't realize that you could do with one of the other accessories that goes along with this set right here. No, it's not the powering part of this. What's going to pull it? It's the hitch. It does have a hitch on it. So if you remove the catapult from this, right, take that away, you can bring in, you can bring in the battle ram and attach it. Remember, the battle ram has a hitch, you can connect it. So you can pull the wagon and the battle ram if you don't want to pull the catapult. How awesome is that? And so there it is, the vintage Mego Planet of the Apes catapult and wagon. A very cool set to have if you can find it complete. That's the thing, because of all those little boulders. And even if you can't find little boulders, if you can just get the wagon and the catapult, that'd be great. Or at least just get the wagon. That's very plenty of us to have that wagon. Too cool. Love it, love it, love it. All right, guys, that's the end of this video. Hope you enjoyed taking a look at this good old classic Meagle vintage toy, the wagon and catapult set that they did for Planet of the Apes in 1975, the Meago vintage days. It's an awesome set to have. I think this is probably my favorite, and probably a lot of you believe the same thing, or believe, well, maybe you don't believe. You think for yourself, right, that is the best one as well, because, you know, as far as Planet of the Apes, you gotta have a wagon. I mean, they're in the movies, right? And they're in all the TV shows, right? The episodes. So the question still is how is this thing powered? Is it powered by having a human pull it? Could have been done. Or an ape, maybe, or something else. But we'll find out what that something else is in the next video. But for now, guys, let me know what you think about this set down below in the comments. And as always, guys, don't stop collecting. Have a great day.